very first step, what you want to do is to take your package of corn husks, which you will find in your kit, and you're going to find that you have several pieces. In fact, we've made certain that we have provided more pieces than you will actually need. So if you wish, you'll actually be able to make several corn husk dolls with your package. And if you ever want to replicate it, these are just corn husks, the types that are usually used to make tamales. But to begin, you can't really fashion a corn husk doll out of dry husks. You have to let them sit in water. So what you want to do is place your corn husks in water and give them at least an hour to soak through. That's going to make it more malleable, and it's also going to allow you to bend the corn husk without it snapping.
Roll them up until they're in a nice little pile like this. And then you're going to fold it in half. This is us making the doll's upper body. So now that you have that, you now begin to tie it off. So take your piece of string. What we're going to do is we are going to begin to create the doll's head. And we do that a really defined head. I keep a little string in the
back because I'm going to
eventually tie it on like this. You see my doll's head. Now I'm going to make a knot. There's that portion of my doll. I've got a little extra left here. I'm going to cut it off. I always say it's better to have too much string when you're tying these than too little, or then you find yourself getting kind of stuck at the end when you need to make that knot tied off. So I can easily grab my scissors, take this last little bit. There she goes. She's bound off. Well, now I have her head portion. Now let's see what we have here. Take that fourth corn husk. Again, like you did with the larger group, and kind of roll it up. Just roll it up, because we're going to start making the arms. Now that you have this, bend this end towards the inside, and bend this other end towards the inside. That way, they're meeting in the middle, and you've got this nice little line.
Just have them meet directly in the middle. Once you have that,
want to make it a little easier on yourself, there is no rule that says you can't use as absolute much string as you like. If you want to tie this off in the middle, you are absolutely welcome to do so. I do think it makes it a little easier, especially if it's your first time making a corn husk doll. I know that when I was little and making these with my granny, that we made everything as easy as possible so that we would have our dolls. That just makes it easier when you take the next step. So there's my little pieces tied together. Make the part with the head.
Now you see you've got this opening here. Insert
what will become the arms right here. And just kind of snug it in. Makes it almost look like a little cross. In fact, you can position it much like one, and that works really well. And once you have that snugly fit in there, a string, and you can tie off the bottom. Go around, and I tie off the bottom. Right. Just snip all my extra string. Now, there you go, you've got the start of your doll's. Her little arms, her body. Some people like to make more defined hems, if you want to do that, all you have to do is tie a little pieces of string here, and it makes her look like she's got little hands. That is up to you. Some people do that. Some people don't. Totally up to you. Now the question is, okay, so where does the dress come from?
This is where it gets a little bit tricky.
And this is where we're going to be paying attention. So the nice thing about us having tied this string here is that naturally makes our doll's waist. It's time to get our other cornhusk pieces out. We're going to begin doing layering and wrapping it around our doll. And it takes a lot more cornhusk than you probably think. At least 8. You can make as many as you want. The more cornhusk that you add, the fuller the dress is going to appear. So again, that is up to you. And note though, the more cornhusk you add to, the more time it takes to dry the doll out. And it will take her at least 24 hours to dry out. You'll begin to see the outer layers drying out, but those inside ones where they've been soaking in wet, it'll take a little bit longer. So you've got the body. You can put that to the side just for a moment. Go grab you a few more wet cornhusks. Got my added cornhusks now. I dry them out a bit. You can take some paper towels, lay them over, dampen them up. That helps too. So the next step is to get another long piece of string. And we're going to begin to layer. So we hold our string in a line. And we basically just fold our cornhusk over the line. See how this is? Now, another thing you want to do, this is another tip. Going to make your life easier. If you want to bind it easier, take your string first and tie it around your little doll's waist. That way you've got a long string that's going around and that's going to begin her dress. So see how I've attached this string to her. Then I'm going to take my cornhusk and I am going to lay it over the top. And I'm going to fold just like this. See, I've given a bit of room here. And I like to take the thinner parts of the cornhusk and fold it over the top. You'll notice with every cornhusk, it spreads out more. And like a dress, you want it to spread out more on the bottom. So, I take my cornhusk, and I do about, I'd say 1-2 inches. Over the top, and then I begin to wrap it around my doll's waist, just like this. And this begins the effect of her dress. Now, I do have to add several cornhusks, so once I get to this end, guess what I do next? I add another cornhusk to it.
And this is the trickier
part. Don't let it frustrate you as you work on it, remember. Fold it over, and I like to fold inward, so you'll see it inward. There's an inch. Sometimes the tops of the cornhusks will split a bit in the end. It doesn't matter if they exactly line up with where your other cornhusk ended. The idea is that you are just continuing the process of wrapping these cornhusks around the doll. Now, when you first begin, as you see here, it seems like it's really thin. It's like, oh no, am I making my doll too thin? It's going to fill out the more cornhusks that you add. But be mindful of your string. You will eventually run out. When that happens, you'll see what happens after I show you. You just bind it, tie it up, cut it, tie another little string around her waist, and keep on going.
And I will add,
too, if you find it kind of unwieldy to deal with this whole thing, you can tear this and work with smaller pieces to build in the folds of the dress. That is absolutely fine. There is no rule that says you can't do that. My string's getting short. This is about as short as I like it to get because I hate it when I get to the end. I'm like, oh, row. This is going far, and then I realize I've run out of straw myself.
Now, what I do now?
I can cut this and start again. Or if I want to, I just take another of my strings. Whatever you think works best for your hands and being nimble
and taking the doll along.
So, see. That's faster.
Going on. Get my dress on. Now, if I wanted
to dye this doll, I would have created my dye beforehand to dye the parts of the dress. I always like, if I'm dyeing a doll and I'm dyeing her dress, what I'll do is I'll make her dress all one color, but then I like to save the one like this and put it towards the front of her apron. But if you were doing the cloth version,
you don't have to worry about that. You just
keep doing what you're doing.
Making her dress. Go all the way around. Now another thing you can be
doing as you're working is you can flip her out. And I'm actually going to end mine there.
She gets a little more fluffy if I keep
going. But I'm not worried about that. So, I'm tying her off.
There she is in all of her glory.
I'm going to cut off some of the little strings. Now the choice is up to you too. And this is when I would do it. Some people love the look of the skirts being uneven. I'm a little bit OCD and not going to even out. While your corn husks are wet, if you are like me and you want those to be evened out because you want her to be able to stand up, I just even it out with my scissors. It cuts really easily. You can
check now to see
if she will stand and mine is standing. I like her. And the basics are done. Now you can still see the little twine and all of that. If I wanted to make myself a fella, which I could, I would just separate my corn husks, tie a little string here, tie a little string there, tie a little string there, you got a little man.
And then
she will be ready for you to
make her little bonnet,
and make her little dress, and make her little apron.
Super easy. Just follow.
Show you how all that fits together. So,
you could see my original doll here. The little template that you
have is going to help you make the dress. The dress is super simple. 4x12. You will fold it.
Cloth. Fold it like this.
That is where her head is going to go. I have a piece of cloth that looks like this. You place this over her head, and then you kind of tuck her clothing in a little bit.
Got like this nice little thing.
Makes her little dress.
Basically a little square
piece that I took and cut into a T. Long little piece of cloth. You tie it in a knot around her little head.
ready to go out. And of course, you can make adjustments
with her dress. I've bunched her up a little bit with this new one.
There we go. There she is. A little bit better.
Give her a little bit more.
You might find
that you want to give her a little more length in some of the pieces of clothing. That's fine. You want to do that. We have provided enough cloth to you in your kit so that you are welcome to do that. She is your doll to love and cherish.
Now, this
is just the very simplest ways to make Husk dolls. Like I said, they can become far more intricate, very beautiful, very detailed. But this is what children enjoy on the Appalachian homestead when they were little. Sometimes it was their only doll that they would encounter. They wouldn't be able to go travel to a bigger city to get a nice porcelain doll or even a cloth doll because those goods might be needed for making their actual dresses. But they could certainly use the scraps that Mama had and that their grandmothers had. As time went on and flour became more prominent in Appalachia after 1885 with the creation of the White Lily Flour Company in Knoxville, it became more common, particularly in the 1920s and 1930s.
You began
to see cloth sacks that carried the flour. It became realized after time that a lot of mamas were saving the cloth to make their little girls' dresses.
And then that cloth,
they began to put patterns on it so that they would feel pretty in those
dresses too. And that became a nationwide
thing. But it's particularly true in Appalachia too. I have some bonnets that were made for my grandmother. They still wore some bonnets in Appalachia even in the 1930s and up until the 1940s. Off their faces if they were working on the barn. And they were very beautifully patterned the cloth. Now the cloth that we've provided you with you in your kit is actually Civil War era patterns. We purchased it from a provider, so you are using a pattern of cloth that came from the time period and would have been worn and maybe would have been saved to make some cute little scraps for your cornhouse doll. I hope you enjoyed making this with me. If you would, we would love to see what you made and how it turned out so that we can share it with others on social media and others who are making the dolls. You can post it on social media yourself and hashtag it with the hashtags that we have provided in the classroom, hashtag AITG Nancy Hanks.
We will
look for those. We will reshare. We hope you enjoy your doll. We hope that you have fun with the process. And we hope you get to make several more and that they become cherished little keepsakes for your home.